Hi guys! Today, I'm gonna tell you about a sport that is unique to Japan. I found a lot of things I didn't know about the background of famous things and even things I didn't know originated in Japan. Let's take a look at them together. Sumo. It is a sport known as national sport of Japan. The rules are very simple. In a circle called the dohyo, use your hand and arms to push your opponent out of the dohyo and decide who wins or loses. If all but the soles of your feet touch ground, you lose. Before a bout, a rikishi sprinkles salt on the ground, then stands on his toes, crouches down, and claps his hands in the air. They do this to cleanse the dohyo, show respect to their opponent, and indicate that they will fight with their bare hands. Then, he steps shiko, cleanses the dirt underneath, and rinses his mouth to cleanse himself. I thought rikishi really loves keeping clean. Sometimes an audience will throw a zabuton into the dohyo even though after rikishi cleansing it. This is called bankuruase, and it happens when a lower ranked rikishi defeats a higher ranked rikishi. It's so exciting event, it's so called a giant killing. If you can, you should watch a live small match at least once. Depending on your seat, you can get change for 3,000 yen so you can enjoy the unique mood of small. Kendo. This is also a very famous Japanese sport. It's a samurai version of fencing. The two fighters strike each other with a bamboo sword called a shinai, and as in fencing, a point is scored when an attack is made on a body's surface. This point is called ippon. There are five effective surfaces: head, wrist, front, throat, or chest, and each of them is called men, kote, do, and tsuki. Player has to shout the name of part when attacks it. Kendo is said to be a sport of strict etiquette. Courtesy such as seiza and zarei are also emphasized during a match, and it is important to remain humble. If you get an ippon and show your pleasure, it will be invalidated, and a point will be deducted depending on the way of wearing a protective gear. By the way, apart from the basic stance, there are other cool stances such as wakigamae and hassou no kamae, which are just like in the anime. What's more, in kendo, it's allowed to use two shinai. It's nitō ryū. This is another cool one, however, no one allowed to use three, so santō ryū. Ekiden. It is a long distance relay in which several people form a team. The most famous relay is the Hakone Ekiden, which takes place over 2 days at the beginning of the year. The distance running in 2 days is about 220 kilometers. The course is characterized by steep mountain roads, and those who win this section of the race and record a good time are called the God of the Mountain. Originally, it seems that Ekiden was started as a qualifier for the American Transcontinental Relay to train Japanese long-distance runners. Unfortunately, the transcontinental relay has never been realized. Kyudo. It is similar to archery, but the rules are different. In archery, the score is different according to the position of the target, but in Kyudo, the score is 1 point if the target is hit anyway. Another difference is that Kyudo has a uniform called Kyudofuku. This is very moe, isn't it? Similar to Kyudo, there is a sport called Yabusame. You ride a horse and ride as fast as you can while shooting at the target, and it requires a high level of physical ability and skill. Link from The Legend of Zelda does something similar. Gateball. Gateball is a game of hitting a ball using a tool called stick and passing the ball through several gates set up in order to reach the goal. It's a game in which everyone competes to reach the goal as quickly as possible, so even if only one player is strong, the team won't win. In addition, gateball is a highly strategic sport in which players not only compete to pass through gates, but also try to hit other balls with their to interrupt opponent. This kind of strategy is used to advance the game in favor of the whole team. The rules of this sport are similar as those of billiards and golf, and it originated in Japan. In Japan, you can see people playing this sport at parks. It is called universal sport because of its simplicity, but it was originally designed for children who do not have anything to play. But in reality, it has been established as a game for the elderly. Makuranage. It is a sport that Japanese students play when they sleep in a group on a field trip, and there is a high probability that they will play it. They float around, throwing their own pillows at their opponents, that's all there is to it. There is usually a watchman, and when the teacher to confirm students' sleep comes, he yells, "Here comes the teacher," and they will pretend to be asleep at the same time. In recent years, this game, in which the player just threw their opponents with pillows, has become a popular sport in many places. I'm gonna show you the rules of the game. A team of 8 players in yukata throws pillow at each other on tatami mats and hits the other player with a pillow. A player who has been hit by a player will be regarded as asleep and will not be allowed to participate in the game. The winner is a team that hits as many players as possible within the time limit to make them to sleep, or the team that puts the opposing team's leader to sleep. There are 4 positions: the general, who is the leader of the team; the liberal, who guards the team with a kilt; the attacker, who puts the opponent to sleep; and the supporter, who brings in the pillows to his team. You can even collect pillows from your opponent's camp by using the teacher is coming call, which has the potential to turn the tables on you. It's amazing what the sport throwing pillows at each other can do. You can have fun with your family if you want, but be warned, it can be quite painful if you don't use a soft pillow. What did you think? I was surprised because an unexpected sport is originated in Japan. It's a mystery whatever the last one can be called a sport anymore. If you are interested, please check out the detailed rules and regulations. Once I'm settling, I'd love to go watch a small match. We'll be introducing a lot of original Japanese things in the future, so if you enjoyed, please subscribe to our channel. See you in the next video, bye!